Very good afternoon and welcome to the live coverage of this match between St. Thomas's and Wesley. Wesley hosting here at Havelock Park on a beautiful afternoon for rugby. Still the early exchanges and a beautiful collection and run there by Tariq Jurampathy, brother of Ishak, who's in the number 13 jersey for St. Thomas's. May have been captaining this team if he chose to stay at his old school, but instead he's playing against them. How fortunes change in school rugby so quickly. And the first scrum of the game, just over the halfway line in St. Thomas's territory, so it'll be an attacking scrum for St. Thomas's, even though they're on the back foot territorially. Watch for Sachit Jayatilaka, one of the mainstays of this St. Thomas's College team, a young player at the back. Much will be expected from him in the years going forward, but Sachita has shown to be one of the few guys who can really take it to quality opposition. The Oliver Goonetilleke trophy up for grabs today for the winner of this game. Qutub Din in at first receiver for Wesley College. The fullback has moved to fly half. And Tariq is at scrum half against his opposite number, De Silva. And that's a terrible ball for Ferdinando in the fly half position. Attacked it nicely, but it was just got a little bit too much pace on it. Ferdy should have probably been a little bit over to the left in trying to collect that ball. But a huge opportunity going begging for St. Thomas's there. It's been the story of their season. They've looked good in patches, but not really been able to put the phases together and finish off tries. Had a couple of players who've been outstanding. Ashwanta Herath at number 12, and Jurampathy has also shown flashes of brilliance. But Wesley coming off a good match against St. Joseph's, 33 points to 15. They lost that one, but were leading at halftime. That'll give them plenty of confidence. Here's Qutub Din with his left foot. Puts it over the wing three quarters head, and that was collected well by Bhuminder Dissanayake, who thumps it down the field. But the referee had seen a penalty. Tackler not releasing. I think he got that call spot on. There were people who fell all over the tackle player in that last breakdown. So a smack down the field from Charmika Kusal, one of the chief try scorers for this Wesley College team, the winger. It hasn't found touch, but referee Dean Imal has found another penalty, and in a much more advantageous position for Wesley. They'll probably look for the line out here. And early pressure mounted by the Wesley College team. It's hard to call anyone favourites in this Oliver Goonetilleke trophy encounter, because St. Thomas has had a pretty dismal season so far. Good win against St. Anthony's last week at Nithavala. Ran up 37 points, and here's a set move from Wesley, one of the old-fashioned ones. But nowhere is where they got. Here's the forward runners thumping it up the middle and close quarters. Kutubdin calls for it. Now he sends it out. That's a good hit up the middle by the fullback, still staying on his feet. That was good ground gained. And now they come back to the open side. But St. Thomas has had the numbers on defense. Charmika Kusal scored several tries and tries to score another one. It's still coming Wesley way, though, as Jurangpati is snaffled just as he gets his hands on the ball. But the referee says there was a penalty and St. Thomas's were offside. Doesn't allow the quick throw, tap, though. And referee Dinimal has a quick word to Ashwanta Herath, one of the other men in this St. Thomas's lineup who have acquitted themselves pretty well. And Kutubdin should probably go for the early points here. But instead, Wesley showing that they mean business and they're going for the try. Another tap and go, and it's a short pass. Good hands from the Wesley forwards. It's available. Good quick ball for Kutubdin with the long ball out, but he doesn't need it. Straight over. Goes the center three quarter for Wesley. Easy does it. A superb run there by LT Avishka. Hit the ball at pace and just cut through the Thomian defense. And this is where St. Thomas's have really been lacking. Wesley exploiting it beautifully. And what I thought was a wrong decision from Kutubdin in not going for the points turns out to be an absolutely superb decision, because they scored that try and Avishka went in untouched. St. Thomas's will really not be happy with that defensive effort. Coach Jeevan Goonetilleke will have mixed feelings about it, because he coached this Wesley College team not too long ago, so he would have brought a lot of these boys up and given them quite a few of the basics that they used in scoring that try. So he'll be happy about that, but he won't be happy about the team he currently coaches that absolutely went to sleep there on defense. Kutubdin with the left-footed attempt, and that goes just wide of the right upright. But early pressure, sustained pressure from Wesley College, which results in a try. And the Thomians, who would have wanted to win this game coming into it, are probably the more fancy team on paper. Suddenly find themselves trailing. Thomians have included Samuel in their starting lineup in the number 14 jersey. As Herath, that's him just dropping the ball there, but it wouldn't have mattered because the restart didn't go 10 meters. Not a very good attempt there, especially after you scored. After you've conceded, rather. Ashwanta Herath needed to give his forward something to run at there. Ahangama restored to the number 7 position for St. Thomas's, with De Silva coming in onto the number 6 position, the blindside flank. As Jurangpati waits to feed. Kutubdin puts it to his boot for Charmika to chase, and it's a well-weighted kick. It's an excellently weighted kick, in fact. Just bounces out into touch. Bhuminder Dissanayake had not read it well, and Samuel, the new man, the young man, doesn't do too well turning back and running at the ball. Sachin Jayatilaka smashing this up the middle, gaining some well-earned yards for his team and winning a penalty as well. That'll settle St. Thomas's down a little bit to see their key player making some yards. Finally with the ball in hand after Ferdinando's knock-on. They haven't really touched the ball in the last few minutes of play. And here's Ferdinando missing a kick terribly again. Tariq Jurangpati under it safely, and Charmika looks to run this one. Here's Kutubdin. He's got support outside him. Stepping back inside is the Wesley support. Mithila Pereira, that was. Here's Jurangpati. Looks for his skipper once again. Upus identified that as their main attacking option. And Samuel gets dragged into touch, but he had very little options there, Samuel. And a lovely kick from Kutubdin, making use of the good ball there. And it has all been Wesley in the last few minutes. So it'll be a Wesley line-out as well, because Samuel got dragged into touch there. First line-out of the match. And it falls to Johan Pereira off the tap-down. But the referee sees that there was a knock forward there. And will award the ball to St. Thomas, who will be relieved to have some possession back. Johan Pereira, the brother of Joel, who played in that champion side of Wesley College a couple of years ago. 2013 team. For St. Thomas's, but no room to run there. And Wesley were ready for it anyway. Number 8 getting across, passing to the vice captain of the side, making a good defensive run. So important for number 8 to run that defensive line straight off the back of the scrum instead of going too far forward. And that's Pasindu again, but Serenayaka for St. Thomas's trying to get in his way and succeeding. The captain doing his job in the line-out, but somehow Wesley have managed to steal this one back, and they roll them all forward. St. Thomas's have brought this down quite clearly, and referee Nimal has his arm out for advantage. Ashwanta Herath steals the ball off Avanta in the tackle there. Avanta, the twin brother of Avishka, who scored the try a little earlier on. So the twins are playing in the midfield. Kutubdin is trying to step his way. That's Avanta. Taken to ground by Wesley, but the ball is available. It's really quick ball for Wesley. They'll be really happy with that as well. Once again, available for Tariq Jurangpati. Snipes, and is he through? Needed to find a support runner. Almost got through Jurangpati. And Dishanayaka putting in a clearance kick there. And St. Thomas is living dangerously. With Wesley making all the running so far, this very young Wesley team, who have come up against some excellent sides so far, have acquitted themselves well in those matches, but today it looks like they really mean business.
He
Abhishek. Bit of a confusion. Previously, I kept calling the scrum Jurangpati, but in fact, it's Avishka, LT Avishka. Jurangpati has moved to the wing, and it's quick ball out for Wesley, and it's a try for Charmika Kusal. An excellent try for Charmika Kusal. Just quick basic hands straight down the line. And this is training ground stuff for Wesley. And you can see why he's one of the top try scorers in this season so far. You can check the stats on thepapare.com where we've got our top try scorers available for you. Malka Gunaratna leading the way, but this man, Charmika, on a team that hasn't scored a lot of points against big schools, has scored a lot of tries. You can see why he's got a real eye for the try line. Haired up from the fullback position where he was in and got in the right position to take that short pass and dive over for a try. Excellent work from Wesley and St. Thomas's. Really not looking like they're going to win this game if they play like this. They've got to get their hands on the ball more than anything else and try and get in the opposition half. Ever since the first or second minute, they've been camped in their own half and winning at them confidently. Kutubdin with the conversion attempt strikes it pretty well and strikes it excellently, in fact. But no, it's just wide of the left-hand upright. Looked very much like it was over from our commentary position. Thomas's body language not really good. So Lee Avishka is the scrum half, just to settle your concerns. There's twins, there's brothers, there's everything on offer here. And Lee Avanthe in the number 13 jersey was the one who scored the try a little earlier on. His twin brother is at scrum half. And Tariq Jurangpati, whose brother is actually playing for St. Thomas's, is on the wing. They look pretty alike as well. Taken by the number 4, Mithil. Makes a big run the second row forward. Wesley with their tails up now. Azwad Hamidon, brother of the second row from a couple of years ago as well. Excellent line out forward, Hamidon. And that ball was thumped deep but into touch on the full. St. Thomas's will finally, through a Wesley College mistake, have an opportunity to get into the half. And now, this is where St. Thomas's must respond with some sort of character. At least go away with 3 points. I'm informed by Fazlan, Wesley College informant, that Mithila Pereira is a brother of Ranjula, who is also part of the CRNFC squad. And again, looks very much like his elder brother in the second row position. So it's a family affair here at Havelock Park in the Oliver Goonetilleke Trophy. St. Thomas is getting the drive on. And referee Nimal missing the fact that Wesley collapsed that one. He was a little too close to the action. And Ashwanta Herat taking a good cut back. Here's Herat. He's going to go on his own, is he? No, he's not. That's an early referee will come back for the penalty. They haven't heard the whistle, and there's a bit of play still going on. But the referee's long since blown the whistle. And he's called them for an illegal entry into the ruck. Into the mall, rather. It was brought down, and it was brought down because of the illegal entry, possibly. Prashwanta Herat should probably have done better, held on to the ball. Scored a superb try against St. Anthony's and thought he had another one. Here's Pandula De Silva going for the line by himself. In fact, here's Pandula now. It's available for De Silva. And now an attacking scrum for St. Thomas's. And in fact, it's a attacking scrum for Wesley off that knock-on. Kasun is the man who has come into the center berth. Colorsman Kasun, who hasn't really found his place in the starting 15, but Jurangpati is off and Kasun is on. So the center combination is Ashwanth Herat and Kasun. Free kick to St. Thomas's. Pandula De Silva to take. Goes hard and straight. And here's Sachita Jayatilaka trying to barge his way over the line. They're using the post to try and keep him up. He's managed to make it available and it's over for St. Thomas's. Finally a try for the Thomians and it looks like the skipper. No, in fact, it's Ashwanth Herat again. Right place at the right time. Jayatilaka made a good drive towards the line after Pandula De Silva's initial run. And Ashwanth Herat was in the right place to pick up the ball and dive over for the easiest try he scored this season so far. And St. Thomas's get the points on the board. It's a five-pointer with perhaps two more to come. And 7-10 will please the bench far more than 10-0 would. Herat smacks it through the uprights, an easy kick for him. And it was an absolutely important score for St. Thomas's to go into half-time. They couldn't have gone in with no points on the board. That would have been really demoralizing for a side that has already taken quite a few hits to their confidence. But Wesley will want to come back and assert the dominance that they have shown for the first half an hour of this game. They're deserved leaders. And they will think that they should be leading by more than 3 points the way this game has gone so far. Chaumika clears the ball towards the 22 off his kickoff, but De Silva, the little scrum half, gets manhandled by the Wesley forwards, but his mates get there to help him out. And Ratnayaka trundles the ball forward. Here's Ferdinando. Here's Pandula De Silva, who leaves the ball behind. Bounces off his ample shoulders into the hands of a willing Wesley player. And Lee Avantha thought he had a counter-attacking opportunity, but it closed down pretty quickly. So another needless handling error for St. Thomas's. Really not showing any fluency in the way they're handling the ball in the face of opposition. Good scrum by the Thomians, but Pasindu manages to pick it up and get it off to his captain, the vice-captain to the captain. And here's Chaumika, their go-to man, Tariq Jurangpati, stopped in his tracks by Hena Kankanamge. And the referee has his arm up for illegal entry into the tackle. And Pandula De Silva thinks he has an opportunity now, but the referee's called it back for the advantage. After the tackle on Jurangpati, the Thomian forwards all entered not through the gate, they entered from the side. And referee Nimal correctly calling that one. Chaumika thumping that one into the Thomian crowd, who have had very little to cheer about so far, not just today, but this entire season. Except, of course, for last week where they beat St. Anthony's to fourth place, which means that they will stay in the top division of schools rugby. Pasindu takes the ball up. And now Avishka gives it to his big forward runners. But conceding a penalty is Mithila Pereira there. Penalty conceded in an attacking position, which was unnecessary for them. Well stolen there by Johan Pereira, but closing the gap, says the referee. Serenayaka taps and goes, the captain. Gets past the first tackle. And now here's Ferdinando with the inside ball to Pandula De Silva. Almost opened up for him, but a bootlaces tackle brings him down. Ashwantha Herath with a good pass out to Kasun. Kasun has got men outside him. Here's Samuel. Needs to stay in the field of play. De Silva. Ferdinando. Mithila Pereira has snuck up in defense. Shuts down any opportunity to go wide. And here's Ferdinando again with a good ball out to Pandula. And now Ahangama with a terrible pass out to Henakan Kanamge. And now the chase is on from Kutubdeen. Kutubdeen picks it up and gets smashed in a tackle. Henakan Kanagbe chases back nicely. Referee's got his arm up for not rolling away in the tackle. And here they go, Wesley, once again with their tails up. Johan Pereira steps inside the flying tackle of the Thomian would-be defender. And here's Charmika once again, dragging him down is Bhumindra Disanayaka. Had to bear hug him to bring him to the ground. And here's Tariq Jurangpati. In at first receiver. They've got men in the middle here. And the referee spots an obstruction there. Didn't really have many places to go, and he went right behind his own teammates. And referee Nima right on the spot. And St. Thomas's live to breathe another day. Ferdinando doesn't strike that one very well either, and picked up by Danny Stagunatilaka on the touchline. Here's Kutubdeen, the captain, puts in a raking kick into space. Sanayaka beaten by the bounce, but recovers well enough to thump this one into touch and bring some sanity back to St. Thomas's proceedings. Avishka, once again to Kutubdeen. Inside ball was feigned, but Danista Gunatilaka gets the pass away nicely. Charmika, it was behind him, but he manages to give it to his wing three-quarter. That was Dinaru Ranavira. St. Thomas get away from the tackle player here, but they're lucky they've got... well, that's an interesting one. Tackler not rolling away, but Wesley were with the ball. So, interesting call there. Thought Wesley might have had a penalty. And again, the touch finder is missed. This is a cardinal sin from the kicker. Charmika into space. Kutubdeen steps inside on his left foot, steps outside and again beats another tackle. That's a lovely bit of stepping from the Wesley captain. Here's Mithila Pereira, who's got a pair of heels on him, and Jurangpati juggles, catches it, the Wesley crowd on their feet. And it's available once again. Really quick ball for Wesley. This is something they've been excellent at, as Hamidon takes it forward. But the referee says there's been a forward pass or a knock forward there. And a shame, because that was a good passage of play from Wesley. Good passing from Charmika. And also Mithila Pereira, who's a ranging second row forward. Quite a bit of skill. It's a pedigreed Wesley side. Skipper Kutubdeen's brother, I'm informed, played for CRNFC a couple of years ago, 3 years ago, in fact. Suhail Kutubdeen, Omar's brother. And it's for Sachita Jayatilaka to attack, which is exactly what he does, but needed to probably do an 8-9-14 move there, because there was a lot of space instead of bringing the forwards back into the game for Wesley. Ferdinando. Jurangpati takes it beautifully, and he's hit as soon as he hits the ground. So perfect timing on the tackle from Hena Kankanamge, and excellent technique also in the tackle from Tariq Jurangpati. Ferdinando finally finds touch. One at the front for St. Thomas's. That's good quick ball finally for the Thomians. Ashwanta Herat bumps off one tackle, manages to get the off. No, he doesn't manage to get the offload away. Kasun was screaming for it, and here's Pandula De Silva. Slow ball for the Thomians once again. Sajid Jayatilaka, Ratnayaka, the prop forward. Johan Pereira getting absolutely smashed at the bottom of that ruck, and Mack goes in. Manages to make it available once again for De Silva, and Ferdinando spots a gap, takes it well. Ashwanta Herath, without any momentum, manages to get back to where they started. And here's Sachita Jayatilaka, needed to look outside, he had men open. And stolen there by Avishka. Beautiful work there from the wing three quarter. An outstanding run from Ranavira. Ranavira is going to go all the way. Is he moving to Nisanaka? Trying to get there. No chance. And Ranavira scores a length of the field try. A mistake from Jayatilaka there when he let the ball go in the ruck and had it stolen. And a lovely swerving run from Ranavira. Didn't need his team's top try scorer outside him, Charmika Kusal. He said, I'll do this one on my own, thank you very much. And a 95-meter run from the Wesley winger. And it was an entertaining try, to say the least. St. Thomas's, with their tails between their legs, trudge back under the posts and wonder what they have to do to beat this Wesley team and get points on the board. The conversion is good from Kutubdin, and it's 17 points to 7. And the Wesleyites will be very important to the halftime break with a 10-point lead. But the way they are playing, they'd want to make it 15. Halftime couldn't come quickly enough for these Thomians. The body language is lethargic, to say the least. And Herath will try not to repeat his mistake from the last kickoff. Samuel has been in cold storage on this wing. He's shown a bit of willingness to get into the action, has got a couple of yellow cards already this season. Good run up by Johan Pereira. Holding on, says the referee. In fact, no, leaving your feet. Mithila Pereira was the man who went down, but Hamidon was the one who left his feet and sealed the ball. You can see Wesley not happy with that penalty giveaway. And Ferdinando will try to find touch, which he does this time. It's not so much about distance in finding touch at this level. It's about just getting the ball outside the touchline. And Ferdinando has failed in about 3 kicks so far, which has lost his team territory as well as possession. Serenike at the back. And that's taken down by Wesley. It's the second time they've done that, and referee Nimal will probably have a word. Taken quickly by Pandula. Excellent tackle on him by Hamidon. And now there's space. Ashwanta Hera takes his own sweet time about exploiting it, though. Kasun tackled in possession. And here's the captain, Serenike, absolutely manhandled there by a bunch of Wesley forwards, a pack of them to bring him down. And Pandula De Silva suffers the same fate. It's very slow ball for St. Thomas is here, because that's the difference between this Wesley attack and the Thomian attack. The speed at which the ball is coming out of the ruck, that is where the difference is. And St. Thomas's are getting slow ball, whereas Wesley are getting very, very quick ball. And the Thomian defense has absolutely no time to reorganize. And Ferdinando puts them back where they started. Serenike again dropped by his lifters. He had to go quite a way across for that throw. Ferdinando on the switch with Ashwanta Herath. Johan Pereira does not let him get any further than he would like. De Silva comes back to the blind side. Lovely step there by Ratnayake, the prop forward, off his left foot. He's done a bit better than some of his three-quarter teammates have. Mack. Herath goes in to try and protect the ball. And referee Dean Imal gives a penalty to St. Thomas's and calls on Hamidon, was it, for a yellow card. In fact, it's Zion Saba, the prop forward, who goes off. So that's a big loss for Wesley, because they've lost a big man, a prop, a front row forward. Satyadeo Jayatilaka trying to go on his own, almost to the line. Still available for St. Thomas's. Mack doubles up with his teammate, flirting with the padding here, St. Thomas's. And here's Ashwanta Herath, way too close to the breakdown, but he manages to borrow his way towards the line. And Ferdinando needs to get it out, needs to get it out again. Kasun, is he over? Excellent defense from Wesley getting across. And the try is scored. It is scored on the far side. Kasun managing to dot that ball down. I thought it was good defense from Wesley at the corner flag, but in fact it's Ferdinando who managed to score that try. Ferdinando on the far side. Managing to dot it down. And St. Thomas has made heavy weather of that, but finally have a score. This could be an exciting game in the second half. 12 points to 17 at the moment with the conversion to come. And halftime soon approaching. So St. Thomas will take some momentum into halftime. Just a breakaway try between the two teams at the moment. The one that Ranavira scored a few moments ago. Carved through the entire Thomian defense on the outside. But Wesley don't look flustered. They'll be happy with that defensive effort that they put up. You know that there's more where that came from. It'll come down to conditioning in the last 15 minutes, maybe 20 minutes of this game. Which team is stronger, which team is fitter, which team is more physically prepared. It doesn't matter what your mind tells you to do if your body can't keep up. So we'll wait and see how that turns out. Ashwant Tahera takes his time over the kick, but does make a difference as it sails wide of the right upright. And that's halftime, ladies and gentlemen. ThePapre.com bringing you live pictures from the Havelock Sports Club ground as Wesley hosts St. Thomas's in the Sir Oliver Goonetilleke Trophy encounter. And Wesley, probably the underdogs going into this game, leading by 17 points to 12 at halftime. A lot to expect from both teams in the balance 40 minutes. And it will be a cracker of a game coming up as we have a family affair here. Lots of brothers, lots of pedigree in this Wesley College team, something that St. Thomas's would kill to have. And we will wait and see whether that pedigree from this young team is enough to see them home with a halftime lead. Welcome back to the live coverage here at Havelock Park of the Sir Oliver Goonetilleke Trophy between Wesley and St. Thomas's College. Wesley, the hosts, are out in front. They've taken their time coming back from the halftime huddle, so clearly their coach had quite a bit to say to them. And they've gone into a huddle which looks very much like a prayer at the start of the second half. 40 minutes more of action before they, hopefully for them, win the Sir Oliver Goonetilleke Trophy. And St. Thomas's would have got a tongue-lashing from former Thomian captain Jeevan Goonetilleke, captained in 2001, captained the Sri Lanka under 20 team as well when they went to the World Cup. But this side has fallen far short of those high standards held by Thomian teams of the past. Here's one man who might be able to spark something for them. Satita Jayatilaka goes down in the face of a good low tackle. Mac, lovely angle from Pandula De Silva. St. Thomas's look like they've come to play in this second half already, but De Silva knocks the ball forward. This has been their weak link, the Thomians. The little scrum half, De Silva, has tried his best. He's limited. And he needs to go in after the ball. And he doesn't really have the stature to take a step before he passes, which means that Ferdinando and all his other first receivers have to stand very close to the breakdown and get hammered by the fringe defense. We saw that just before the halftime break when Ashwan Teherath had absolutely no purchase, no momentum. And the first scrum of the second half is not stable, so referee Didimal blows it up. Just in case you're wondering about the rule here, the referee calls the set and the scrum needs to be stable. And the reason it's not stable is because Johan Pereira, the flanker, has gone into the front row. Because if you remember, just before halftime, Zayan Sabar was given a yellow card. And a penalty goes to the seven-man side. That's unforgivable from St. Thomas's, giving away a penalty to a seven-man scrum. Here are the twins, Avishka and Avantha. Avantha, that was, who got back up to his feet, wasn't held in the tackle. Here's Avishka. Long pass from Kutubdeen to Charmikara. Lovely dummy, an absolutely stunning dummy from the hooker, and he's over. Charmika Kusal has scored the first try of the second half for Wesley and extends St. Thomas's lead. A stunning bit of play from Hamid on the hooker, hanging about on the wing. And that was a dummy that Eric Rush would have been proud of. Cut the defense wide open, and Charmika Kusal, this boy is not playing in a big team. And you look at wingers like Petya Goda, Goonetilleke, you look at Punchiheva and Gal Lage, but for me, a guy with an eye for the trial and a guy who hits the angles beautifully, Charmika Kusal, has really stood out for me today. An outstanding run from him. Ran onto the pass from Hamidon, and a beautiful bit of work there from the entire Wesley team. And I cannot say enough about this young Wesley side. They have really lit up Havelock Park today as Kutubdeen thumps that one over for a perfect start to the second half for Wesley. Clearly, whatever they said at the halftime huddle has worked for them. And St. Thomas's really need to line up their men and make those first-time tackles. A lot of people would argue that the Thomians are losing these matches because of their attack, but that's not the case. They're losing it because they don't make their tackles. And if you don't tackle, you can't play rugby. It's a very simple equation. Ashwan Teherath, one of the few boys who might make it into an opposition 15. Kusal Ranavira, in fact, the try scorer, previous try scorer, runs straight into the opposition with some confidence, but there were hands in that ruck. And St. Thomas's now have to bridge a 12-point gap. Ferdinando sneaking another couple of meters from the referee's mark there, as all good fly halves do. But Ferdinando also does. So St. Thomas's have dropped a couple of players back, probably for the inside ball from Ferdinando. There's Satyajaya side shoulder, and Ratnayaka, the flank forward who started a few games for the Thomians, but it doesn't matter at all because it's overthrown. And the ref having a word with the Thomian captain there and says, I told you to wait, mate, so wait for my whistle. See whether they change the call here, St. Thomas's. They really have only one line-out option. That one went to Ahangama though. And that maul also brought down. So Wesley on a yellow card. Need to be a little careful here. Satyajaya Tilaka taps and goes. It's the second time he's done that. And they scored a try off the last time. But here's De Silva. Absolutely clumsy at the base. But Mack trying to do something as Pandula De Silva turns. And Ashwanta Herat scores. Looked very much like it was Herath with his second try. We'll tell you in a moment as he gets up. And yes, it is Ashwanta Herath. So it looks very much like Sir Thomas's won't score any tries if not for this man. But another very similar try from the first half. Satyajaya Tilaka tapping and going. And then the ensuing melee and Ashwanta Herath with an eye for a try. Picks it up and swings the try line to score. Finished it well. It takes some skill even to score from that distance. It's not as easy as it looks sometimes. You've got to make sure the ball is available to be grounded. And Ashwanta Herath did that in some style. Serenayaka, the captain, finding it necessary to oversee Ashwanta Herath's conversion. He's happy with it. And the Thomians, who needed to bridge a deficit, have got seven of them.
Just take a photo and see if you can sort it out.
Quick throw from Wesley. Charmika, nice long pass from him. Kutubdeen, the skipper, can step only in one direction. That's a bit of a weakness in his game. Can only go off his left foot. Good counter-ruck by St. Thomas's there, have won themselves a penalty. In fact, they've won themselves a knock-on, so they've won a scrum. Sabar waits impatiently to come back on, and he will be on in the next couple of moments, and that he is in fact on now. So Wesley restored to their full confidence. They managed to score a try in the absence of one of their team members. But they also did concede one. So here's Sabar after a nice rest. Comes back into the front row on the loose head side. Jayatilaka has plenty of options here. A nice open blind side with a gap to hit and two men outside. He goes instead to De Silva. De Silva doesn't draw anybody and puts Ashwanta Herath into the traffic. Here's D.T. Ratnayaka again to his front row buddy, Pandula De Silva. That pod of forwards has worked hard but to little effect. Ferdinando puts it straight down the throat of the most dangerous runner in the Wesley team. And Charmika Kusal showing that he has way more than one shell in his armory. and thumps a kick beautifully onto the 5 meter line and puts tremendous pressure on the Thomian line out. It was a nothing kick really from Ferdinando to their most dangerous player, and he thought, I've cut this defense up already twice today, let's just show them I can kick as well. Senanayake wins that one well under pressure, and Mack will run it out of trouble. And De Silva, really, that's a terrible option from De Silva. Ran into the big forwards and now has given away a penalty. This is a huge, huge, huge weakness for the Thomian team. I can see why Coach Jeevan Goonetilleke was toying with the idea of playing Ishak Jurangpati at the halfback position. And here is a bad pass, one of the few bad passes that we've seen from Wesley. And not approaching the tackle through the gate, says the referee to Lee Avishka, the scrum half, the twin. It's a better kick from Ferdinando. Takes his team almost up to the 40-meter mark. Avishka and Avantha, the twins for Wesley College. There were twins that played for St. Thomas's as well, Jayan and Jeevan Goonetilleke in 2001. Romesh and Dinesh Fernando in 98. It's overthrown, so it's a knock forward. And Wesley will gladly take the scrum, which also gives a nice 15-meter blindside for Pasindu. Let's see whether the Wesley vice captain makes use of it. Instead, they go straight to the open side. Kutubdeen. Swiveling out of a tackle is Charmiga Kusal, the danger man. Kutubdeen thinks about the kick. And Ferdinando's tackle means that he gives his opposite number a few more meters. Kutubdeen, not held, so rolls in the tackle. And another penalty coming Wesley's way. And the referee looks like he's going to be giving a yellow card to Sachit Jayatilaka, who left his feet in contesting that ball. And St. Thomas's lose their most influential forward. And Kusal, who for me really is a shoo-in to any Sri Lanka side here, from just from the little that I've seen in today's game. Wesley having more problems with Kutubdeen. Limping in back play. He's got a fairly severe cramp by the looks of things and may seem to have also got a bit of a head knock. So a replacement coming into the field of Wesley College in the number 25 jersey. Marshid Zubair. As Wesley will aim to keep this one with the forwards. They've lost their captain at the back. But it's been a team performance from Wesley so far, so they won't miss him too much. Zubair goes in, and filling in at first receiver is Avantha, the try scorer today that scored the first try. Here's Zubair. Lovely work by Kusal. On of run. Desperate defense from the Thomians, and here's another penalty coming their way for Wesley. Here's Avishka. Gives it to his big forward runner. Mack makes a good tackle. But it's still available. Numbers on the outside. Zubair swings it quickly. Danista Goonetilleke with a good inside ball. Should probably have given it earlier and straightened the line. But St. Thomas has come away with it. And Gunatilaka's attempted offload. doesn't really help as he gives the ball away and Ferdinando is forced to thump it into touch on the full from behind his goal line. And as a net result, I think the Wesleyites will be happy with that because they've got a line out to attack now. And just in that phase of play, I think Marshid Zubair, the man who just came on to replace his captain at fly half, looks very, very young, but looks like he knows what he's about. Was everywhere in that move and spins it through the hands quickly. This lad may be one to look out for. Really, a lot of promise shown from this Wesley side. And look out for them in the upcoming years, next year and the year after that, because I'm informed that they're a very young team. They've punched above their weight this season, although they've lost games. And that was well won there by Pasindu, their vice-captain. Sets up them all nicely. They've got a big man at the back who is Hamidon. And bringing it down is the Thomian captain, or attempting to bring it down, but it's stayed on. Hamidon goes down with the ball. They've got to find a willing runner here. Straight through the middle. Avishka, here's Zubair. Zubair with the quick ball out to Pasindo. Lovely short pass there. A brilliant short pass to Avantha. It's available once again for Wesley, and they've scored an outstanding try once again. That looked like it was Hamidon, was it? Beautiful work from the Wesley forwards there at close range. There was a super pass from Pasindu. In fact, it was Danista Goonetilleke to his center three-quarter partner. Lovely short ball that opened up the defense, sucked in the Thomian outside defenders. And from then on, there was only one team that was going to get the better of that exchange. And Wesley have really shown some outstanding skills here today at Havelock Park. And they deserve to be in front by 29 points to 19 with a conversion to come. That's terrible luck for Jamika Kusal. Can't have it all his own way, I guess. Did really well scoring tries, but he's also a place kicker. And managed to find the upright with pinpoint accuracy. But he don't get points for that jump. St. Thomas's really don't look like they want to get on with it. They're not playing like a team that want to chase this game and win it. And as I've been writing about them, it's not so much as skills on the rugby field as Tariq Jurangpati makes a massive run out of that of his own 22. But well won there by Pandula De Silva. Got himself out isolated. Now chance to counter-attack. Here's Ashwanta Herath. They've got men outside. Kasun, the try scorer. Kasun still goes. Bhumindra Disanayake in support. Now it's available for Herath. Waits for De Silva. Ferdinando. It's a nice step through the middle by De Silva. They've still got it, but managed to steal it, did they? No, St. Thomas still have it. And the scrum half puts it down on the ground. I have no idea what this little scrum half is doing, De Silva. Seems to have no coordination on who wants the ball, where they want it. Doesn't seem to look up before he passes it. Seems to look up only when he has the ball in his hands. And sometimes that's a little too late, mate. St. Thomas's at sixes and sevens in the backs. Not really sure who's making the calls here. It looks very much like Avantha, Ashwanta Herath. But Ferdinando also needs to be making the calls as fly half. And when they're on two opposite sides of the field, it can get a bit hairy. And Wesley spin this one round. What does referee Nimal say? He says nothing. Play on. It's available now finally for Ferdinando. Here's Herath. Herath will put his pedal to the metal, so to speak. But not going anywhere because he's taking the ball so shallow, so flat. Pandula de Silva. Here he is now. De Silva, the other De Silva, the flanker, takes it into contact and Mack goes straight to ground. Here's Ferdinando, juggles the ball. It's a long pass out to Kasun. Kasun takes the direct route. It doesn't do him any favors. Didn't try to stay in the field of play and make things easier for his support players. And there's the flanker, De Silva, who's had a couple of good runs, drops it cold. And that's a sign of a side with absolutely no confidence. So St. Thomas's have so much ball and are butchering it. And finally a change is made. And scrum half comes onto the field for St. Thomas's. Scrum half Gamage replaces De Silva. And Gamage looks like he's been born for about a week. He's a tiny, tiny man. Looks like his mom put him in his nappies. And that just goes to show the desperate lack of depth in this Thomian side. Hamidon out for Wesley as well. The replacement is made, and here's another replacement at number 23. It was a scrum against the head for St. Thomas's. Well done there. And here's Gamage, who gives quick ball. Pandula De Silva takes that ball nice and flat again. You can see where the difference is. Gamage has already come on and made a difference. He's not got a great pass on him, but he's getting it to ground quickly. Big hit on the replacement by Ishak or by Tariq Jurangpati. Means that the ball gets lost forward. Referee didn't see anything wrong with that tip tackle. And in the centers is Cara, another youngster. Ferdinando has seen his match come to an end as Ashwant Herath fills in at fly half. Probably not the most effective position to play Herath, as defenses will be coming at him. And he takes a bit of time to get moving, Ashwant Herath. He's very big in his lower body, so takes a while to get moving. Satish Jatilak has also come back as St. Thomas has destroyed the Wesley scrum. So this is what I talked about conditioning being important. And let's see whether the strength of this bigger Thomian pack will hold them in good stead in the last 10 minutes of this game. Need to make sure they exploit that strength and physicality in the front. Ratnayaka, the prop forward, who has a bit of a taste for scoring tries, gets almost to the line himself. And the penalty is coming for St. Thomas's. Gamage gives it. Probably should have gone himself. The Thomians are inches short here. And this is Ashwant Herath for his hat trick, and he's over. Ashwant Herath scores his hat trick. And if you've been 2 minutes of play when compared to the last several minutes of play, you can see the difference that a scrum half of competence can make to a side. He doesn't have to be George Grigg and he doesn't have to be Justin Marshall, just needs to be a guy who can pick the ball up and pass it flat. And you can see what a difference he's made to the Thomian attack, the pace of the Thomian attack. And that's where Wesley were suddenly uncoordinated in their defense because the Thomians were attacking much faster than they had been for the last 70 minutes. So that replacement probably should have come about half an hour before it did. So 26 points to 29. And despite playing some excellent rugby, Wesley are still very much in danger of losing this game. And the Thomians finally with some replacements coming in. With some fresh legs, some talented young players are injecting a little bit more urgency and desire into winning this match. Sachita Jayatilaka calls for it, but instead it goes to the number one, Gamage. He's got a box kick as well. It's not a great one, but at least he's tried it. It's knocked forward. And here, Nanyakara. Not a good pass to Henakan Kanamge, who picks up the ball and drops it cold again. It's a comedy of errors. Nanyakara's pass was too hard, it has to be said. But Henakan Kanamge, after palming it backwards, in fact, it's not Henakan Kanamge, it's VT Ratnayaka, the flanker. Good scrum by St. Thomas is putting real pressure on Pasundu De Silva. Good tackle by Ratnayaka. Marshid Zubair tackled in position. And here's the number three, Shamel Amit. Tariq Jurangpati wants a piece of the action himself. And here's Avishka, the little scrum half. It's been so good today. Charmika, probably my man of the match so far, puts the kick in, and it's a well-judged kick. Ashwanta Herat is just charged down, but a knock forward had happened before that. Otherwise, that could have been all sorts of trouble for St. Thomas's. And you can see again, despite Gamage being a shade better than his predecessor, there's a necessity for the fly half to stand so close to the breakdown that he gives himself absolutely no chance to move away from the defense. The defense swarms him before he can do anything, really. Which is why you need a scrum half who can pass 15 meters. And St. Thomas certainly haven't had that for long periods of the game today. So it's 29 points to 26. A real humdinger of the last 5 minutes to be expected. Wesley, the underdogs, a young team, coming into the Sir Oliver Goonetilleke Trophy, showing that they're here to play rugby against their old coach, Gamage. Ashwanta Herath, deciding that he has to run the guy who scored a hat-trick already. You can't fault him for thinking that he's got to do it all on his own. Here's Henakan Kanamge to Kasun. Kasun puts it to his boot. Why he kicked that ball away, I would never know, especially not to the danger man. Charmika Kusal. But they are lucky to win a penalty, St. Thomas's. They'll have to kick the line out and attack from there because it's just a 3-point game. On the 10-meter line inside the Wesley territory. Do St. Thomas's have 40 meters of good rugby left? Senanayaka takes the call to himself. That's good responsibility by the captain. Bang up the middle goes Ratnayaka. It to ground goes the big prop forward. St. Thomas's have done little to stay on their feet today. Hena Kankanamge looks for Kasun. Kasun goose steps, comes back in. This is better from Kasun. He should have been doing this all evening. Kamage goes in after it. Ashwan Tahira takes it standing. St. Thomas is playing static rugby. Absolutely no depth to their forward, to their back line. Satya Jayatilaka gets a good ball away to Pandula De Silva. Here's Samuels, the first time he touched the ball today. Is it going to be a telling time? Isolated, needs to get there, the forwards. Gamage screaming for his men to get there. Now they do. Sachita Jayatilaka. Wesley desperately defending. St. Thomas is desperately attacking. And the penalty is coming for St. Thomas's. Here's Nanyakkara, the new man. Hena Kankanamge runs into traffic. Bhumindra Disanayake, one of his few touches this afternoon. Still going, St. Thomas's. They've got some momentum now. Gamage, Ashwanta Herath. Here's Pandula De Silva. Block tackle to the ground. Has a high center of gravity, Pandula. If you go low, he gets it. Sachita Jayatilaka can't get it away. Good tackle on him by Mithila Pereira. Ashwanta Herath. Here's S.D. Ratnayake, the prop forward. Needs to keep the ball available. St. Thomas can't afford to make a mistake. That's a massive bump off by V.T. Pereira. And here it is available for Jayatilaka. Jayatilaka gives, or should have given it to Samuels. But manages to get the ball back, and there's an advantage coming for the Thomians. Here they go, the captain almost to the line. And it's available now for Jayatilaka, and he scores. That's the win for Wesley, for St. Thomas's rather. That was desperate attacking. Did St. Thomas's have 40 meters of rugby, I asked you? And the answer is yes, they do. Saving their best bit of rugby for the last 5 minutes of the game and breaking the hearts of these Wesley supporters who have been such a fantastic crowd this afternoon. Behaved themselves absolutely exceptionally in the face of a team playing brilliant rugby. But the bigger team, the stronger team, the team that just hung in there, looks like they've won the match. And Gamage will try to make this a 5-point margin. As a hush comes down across Havelock Park. And Gamage, the youngster, who's got a boot on him, puts the kick over. And I'll tell you what, if Gamage had started this game, St. Thomas's would have won by 20. Wesley have played well, I have to say. They have played the better rugby for 75 minutes of this game. But sport is a terrible, cruel thing sometimes, that this young Wesley side will learn from this experience. St. Thomas's will look for the restart and they'll want to clear this one. Gamage does exactly that. From Chamika Kushal, does he have a moment of magic in him? Here's Tariq Jurangpati, who's been anonymous for much of this game with the ball in hand. Will want to show his brother he did the wrong thing by leaving the double blue to the blue and black. I'll tell you what, Ishak Jurangpati would have had a proper earful when he got back home today if Wesley win this game. And that's a ball straight through the hands of Avantha. Scored the first try, trying to see whether he can score the last. Here's Zubair. Tackle to the ground. And a penalty is coming for St. Thomas's. Here's Kasun. Needs to give the ball out. He had men outside him. And the penalty comes St. Thomas's way. The question on everybody's minds is how much time is there left on referee Nimal's watch? Remember, Wesley came out a little slowly from their halftime huddle. So we may have a few moments. There's been a couple of injuries in this half. And Gamage has the luck of the bounce. And Durangpati makes a bit of a hash of it. I'm told by the Thomian media unit that it's not Gamage, that it's Dias in the number 22 jersey. It may be Dias Gamage because his initials are D and D. Do not disturb. But it could very well be Dias Gamage. Because there's no Dias on our team sheet. We've been thoroughly let down, I must say. The Papare.com have been thoroughly let down by a lot of the teams, not just St. Thomas's and Wesley today, but several teams in the giving of the team sheets to the commentary position. Teams have to realize that this is the medium by which a lot of their matches go abroad and go to many parts of the country. And this is what you can come back and watch after you've played the game. Come back and have a watch, and you don't want me or anyone else calling your name wrong. And just help us out with making sure that we get the proper information to our fingertips. It's not a lot to ask. It's just two sheets of A4 paper, properly filled. And if you're a master in charge of a rugby team, you should be able to fill a form with 15 or 23 names on it. St. Thomas is now looking to close this game out. It's 29 points to 33. A try will still win it for Wesley. They've already scored one 95-meter try today. Do they have another one in them? Not with the way this Thomian pack is mauling them, though. Charmiga Kusal at first receiver. It's a bump ball. Do we have a stunning run here? We've had 40 meters. Is there 60 more? And St. Thomas, that ball, knocking it forward, is Wesley. And referee D. Nimal having a word. This is the worst thing that can possibly happen for the Thomians, that they'll put more time on the clock here. Their supporters need to be behind the line. They need to be not encroaching into the technical area where the benches are. And I must say, the Wesley crowd on this pavilion side of the Havelock Sports Club have been a very civilized set of supporters. They could be watching a cricket match at Lord's. They've been cheering their team, but still very, very composed. There's very little face palming when their team went behind. Seem to be able to accept victory and defeat with equal grace, and that's a lesson to a lot of supporters, as Dias or Gamage puts over the kick. I'll tell you what, we don't know what his name is, but this lad has been an absolute revelation since he came back onto the field for St. Thomas's. And I'll stand by my statement earlier, if he started this game, St. Thomas's would certainly have won by 20. What possessed Jeevan Goonetilleke to keep starting De Silva? I will not know. I will ask him, though. Lovely touchline conversion. Ashwan Tahera takes his time and thumps it out on the full. But luckily for him now, a converted try can only draw it for Wesley. And I'll tell you something, else. A draw will not be an undeserved result. St. Thomas's have come back from the brink to lead. But Wesley, I must say, played the better rugby for 70 minutes of this game. and they deserve to take something out of it, and a draw I think would be a fair result for what we've seen today at Havies. The Sir Oliver Goonetilleke trophy will be shared if that's the case, and Wesley have a few moments in which to do it. Pasindu wins it beautifully at the top. Avishka Zubair gives it to Danista Goonetilleke, but there's a knock forward as Nane Akkara smashes the number 23, Avantha Hashan, into the ground. And here's Kasun with his tail up now. Jay Kasun, the colorsman for St. Thomas's, coming off the bench to replace Durangpati. Ratnayaka gets the ball ripped from him, but it gets knocked forward by the Wesley defender. VT Pereira does well. Gamage tries to look for the raking grubber kick, but it comes off a boot. Gamage gives it to Ashwanta Herath. Herath should probably have just thumped it down into opposition territory. Here he is now, Bhumindra Disanayake, with the long ball out to Samuels. Samuels will put it to his boot, but Wesley recovered it beautifully. And here's Charmika Kusal, offloads nicely to Danista Goonetilleke. Danista does well to keep the ball available for his scrum half, Lee Avishka. And choosing to put it to his boot is Zubair. And the ball bounces in the field of play and stops. Samuels now looks to step this one into some trouble. And that's exactly what he finds. Leaving their feet, the Wesley team have one final chance, is it? Here it is now. Charmika Kusal gives it to Avantha Hashan, dragged down by Ashwanta Herath. Here's Kusal now at first receiver, taking the responsibility, the senior man. It's a lovely short pass once again. A superb offload from Wesley. They've been much better in this department, in the fluency of their backline. And that's stolen away from St. Thomas's, by St. Thomas's rather. And DNB Gamage gets this one away onto the short side. Here he is again, gives it away to his replacement. Tackled well, and that's another good one even at this late stage of the game. Here's Henakan Kana, looks to Kasun, who puts in a judicious kick straight down the ground, and that's the end of the game. It's been an absolutely cracking match here at Havelock Park. St. Thomas's have come away with a win, but this Wesley team can hold their heads up high. And you can see what it means in the crowd. A Thomian team that has suffered some ignominious defeats this season have come from behind and pulled off a magnificent victory. Ashwanta Herath, the hero of their win, he scored all the points with his boot, as well as three of the tries that St. Thomas scored. It was an outstanding individual performance from him, but also a desperate performance from a team that showed some character to come through and win this match. And Wesley hang their heads, but not in shame. They hang their heads in disappointment, because that was a game they could have won. And this Wesley team will go places, I'm telling you, in the next couple of years. Congratulations to them for a brilliant performance, but bigger congratulations for St. Thomas's for coming from behind, really hanging in there towards the end of the game to win the Sir Oliver Goonetilleke trophy by 36 points to 29. An outstanding game of rugby. The crowd on the edge of their seats right through it. And congratulations once again to the Thomians for putting another trophy back into their cabinet. We'll be back with a lot more action with the second leg of the Bradby coming up next week before the break is over. And we're back with second round action in the week after. Stay tuned to thepapare.com, where we're sharing all the passion. Thanks a lot to the media unit of St. Thomas's College for their help on this broadcast, and also to Fazlan from Wesley for a great job that he did in assisting with the commentary as well. It has been a superb game to call. Thanks very much for joining us. We'll see you next time on thepapare.com.